public participation comment card here and says you're a parent.
I am.
Floor is yours.
All right, thank you. These are the policies, promises, procedures, protocols, and Wisconsin DPI standards that the administration failed to follow through with on Silverbrook and Badger concerning Corrine's speech and what happened to her son. On the DPI website, there is WISHES, the Wisconsin Improving School Health Services Project, that states that every school has an emergency procedure for illness. And one of the things listed is the responsible authority or designated employee should notify the parent. Failed. In the parent handbook for our schools, on bus safety, just to keep in mind, it states to provide a safe and pleasant bus ride, and the bus is considered an extension of the school. Now for this policy, that will be pertinent. Policy to suspend a student in our school district for conduct while at school or under the supervision of school authority, which endangers the safety and health of others. Failed. What's the policy to expel in our district? You can be expelled for engaging in conduct while at school under the supervision of school authority and endangering the health and safety of others. Failed. West Bend School District Policy 882. The following guidelines are to be used by administrators when a police liaison or law enforcement officer interviews a student at school. Notify the parents and guardians when the student, if they are a minor, and inform them before the meeting takes place. Failed. The policies, policy 443.71, anti-bullying, failed. Policy on items prohibited on school property, weapons of any sort, or items that could be construed as weapons, failed. Parent-student handbook, sick or injured at school. If your child requires treatment beyond first aid, we will call the emergency contact or the child's home, failed. And Corrine's son would have been looked at by the school nurse, there are probably more, but I only printed out three procedures that should take place. Bites, human or animal, this was obviously a human bite. There are 16 steps, every single one of them was ignored. One of them is contact the parent and urge immediate medical care because it's so serious. Head injury, when he got hit in the head on the bus, when he knocked his glasses off, 14 steps. Every single one ignored. One of them is contact the parent and urge medical care because that's very serious. Puncture wounds. Did he have a puncture wound? No one at the school would know. They never looked. 14 steps, all ignored. The administration at Silverbrook and Badger failed to not only Corrine and her son, but they ignored signs to get this attacker help before it went this far. I hope the board takes this seriously and disciplines these administrators for negligence and expels that student. Thank you.